Hello, I'm Dave Aniski, and you're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel. In the video today, we're looking at how clownfish manage to breed despite that they're all born male. Let's get started. Clownfish, also known as anemonefish, are sequential hermaphrodites that first develop into males. In fact, they live in regimented schools made up of all males and just one female, the lone female being the dominant and generally the largest fish in a given group. The second in command of the school is usually the largest and most aggressive male of the group. Due to his dominance of the other males, he'll tend to ensure they stay small via taking the best food opportunities for himself. Besides the perks of more food, he's also the only one that gets to breed with the female. During the breeding, the female will lay sometimes thousands of eggs, depending on the species and her size, usually on a pre-cleaned rock or coral close to the anemone she lives in. After the eggs are laid, the male will go along and fertilize them. From here, if a given egg is poor quality, whether damaged, i.e. Nemo, or it becomes infected by a fungus or the like, the male will typically eat the egg. Likewise, if the egg is infertile or if the clownfish is an inexperienced breeder or stressed, he may also simply eat the eggs. Otherwise, the male, and rarely the female, will guard the eggs for the 6 to 10 days it takes to hatch, as well as regularly fan them, which increases the chances of the eggs successfully developing. After the eggs hatch, the parent's job is done and they have nothing to do with the baby fish, who ascend to the surface and feed on plankton until maturation. If the female dies, the dominant male will get the first choice of food and begin to gain weight, ultimately becoming female. She'll then choose a breeding partner among the available males, which is usually the largest and most aggressive male available. At the same time, everyone else moves up one in the pecking order. The two will pair off and breed together until something happens to one or the other, at which point the cycle begins again. It's thought that this peculiar ability to change sex developed because, unlike many other types of fish, clownfish almost never stray very far away from their homes and sea anemones, which they form a symbiotic relationship with. Thus, if not for the ability to adapt to potentially limiting mating partners in their local area, they may not get a chance to breed at all. And while we're on the topic of Finding Nemo-related facts, you might be interested to know that whales do not blow water out of their blowholes. Further, the whale's trachea doesn't connect to the esophagus of the whale, so when Dory and Marlin went down the whale's throat, in real life, they'd have simply been eaten. You might at this point be wondering then why it looks like whales do blow water out. We've covered this in great detail in this video, but briefly, when the whale resurfaces, they have to release the used up air back into the atmosphere, just like all other mammals do. This does result in a spout, but it isn't ocean water. The air inside the whale is typically quite warm from the whale's body heat. When it's exhaled, it meets the much cooler temperature of the air outside and immediately condenses, making it look like a spout of water. The air is also often mixed with mucus. It is a nose, after all. Another interesting thing to note is that, as a rule, baleen whales, those whales who don't have teeth but rather have baleen plates to filter food out of the water, like the one depicted on Finding Nemo, have two blowholes, while toothed whales have just one. Types of baleen whales include the blue, gray, and humpback whales, the latter of which was the one depicted on Finding Nemo, even though it was shown with just one blowhole. Another whale of an error in Finding Nemo is when they depict the humpback whale as having a uvula. Whales don't have those. So thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, please click that like button below and consider sharing it with anyone you think might be interested. And of course, if you're new to Today I Found Out, don't forget to click that subscribe button to get more interesting videos like this. We release a new video almost every single day, so you're sure to find something you find interesting. Thanks for watching.